All right, welcome back, everybody. It's been a tough go of things lately for the governor when it comes to the legislature. With the state facing major budget shortfalls and the looming expiration of $1.3 billion in annual tax collections for next year. Now, this was supposed to be the session that addresses all that, but after the governor's value-added tax on businesses failed to make it out of the committee yesterday, came the news that the governor's package of income tax changes were rejected by the House. While he visited our studio today, I had the chance to ask the governor about the battle to balance the budget.
Nobody's going to be completely happy because the compromise is such that when you have the shortfalls of the type we're talking, over $400 million a year starts July 1st. July 1st, 2018, right now, the cliff is $1.3 billion. And as of right now, with only a few weeks left to go in the session, the last fiscal session before we hit that cliff, the House has done nothing. I mean, absolutely nothing to address that cliff. And we've got a lot of work to do. Otherwise, we're going to have special sessions, which we shouldn't need to have. There won't be any options on the table for us that are better a few months from now or early next year than we have right now. And so I'm calling upon all of the members of the legislature, Republican and Democrat, and Independent, House and Senate. We need to get serious and do the people's work.
That's what the House members keep saying. Some of them is that the state's spending out of their means and that they're always having these mid-year special sessions to try and fix the budget deficit.
Yeah. Now, we have real challenges. That $2 billion in state general fund deficit that I inherited for the current fiscal year is a huge number. Mm-hmm. Ultimately, the legislature decided to address it primarily with a penny of sales tax that was on a temporary basis. That penny is going to expire June 30th of 2018. That's what causes the cliff. But in the meantime, the legislature said we want to set up a task force to study comprehensive long-term budget and tax reform. Mm-hmm. And then we will enact that tax reform before the cliff arrives. Well, now is that time. This is the last fiscal session before the cliff. They're rejecting everything the task force did. Yeah. They rejected the things that I put forward. It's okay for them to have 80% of our corporations paying no income tax, and they don't even want to give 90% of our individual income taxpayers a tax cut. You know, that was part of the task force report too. You broaden the base, you lower the rates, you make the state competitive. We had an opportunity, my plan, to give 90% of Louisiana's income taxpayers a small tax cut and to make the 80% of corporations who are not paying anything start paying their fair share so that we can right our ship, so that we can invest in K-12 education, higher education, health care, make sure that we can do all the things we need to do in Louisiana. But they have rejected all of those approaches without advancing any of their own. It is the height of irresponsibility. It is time for them to start acting seriously.
You think you guys could come to a consensus eventually? I mean, most of your tax proposals have been killed, especially yesterday, the income tax.
Well, yeah, it's my hope. There's still enough instruments there. When I say instruments, I'm talking about bills, that we can get a lot of good work done. It is not outside the realm of possibility. I'm less hopeful now because I don't see much willingness to do anything. You know, difficult times require courage. Nobody likes cuts. Nobody likes revenue. Nobody likes a balanced approach when you're doing both of those. But we have to do something.
And generally in the